views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. Welcome to the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegell. Artie is renowned psychic medium, spiritual life coach, and entertaining motivational speaker. Sky's given talent of inner guidance gives her the ability to interpret feelings and images impressed upon her by the spirit world. Call now for answers from your guardian angels and loved ones at 800-930-2819. And now here are your hosts, Artie and Sky.
Welcome, everybody, to another wonderful week of Angels and Answers, where your answers will be right here. Hi, Artie.
Hey, how's it going? So this week, we're really excited, and we want everyone else to be excited because Sky and I are going to be doing a live show at the Stress Factory on November 2nd, and we're going to be doing stand-up comedy, and we're going to be doing readings for the audience, and we're going to be connecting to dead people in the audience, and hopefully the dead people aren't in the audience.
Oh, they'll be. They're going to be.
I'm sure some of them will be, and so it's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to be having the Rocky Horror Film clippings of the dance there and the Michael Jackson Thriller video. And
are we going to dance?
Yeah, we'll dance, of course. I'm a dancer.
I'm a dancer, too. You know that. We're the only ones that dance when we go out, right?
No, the others were dancing. We weren't. Maybe
no.
Really?
It was only you and I. We got up to dance.
I don't know. This is true. This is
right.
So it's going to be a lot of fun. And so check out, go to the events page, go to my events page, artiehoffman.com. And so it's really cool. And it's going to be a lot of fun. And it's for a very good cause. We're raising money to help out this gentleman. His name is Carl, who has major medical bills. And we're going to have
no insurance, the poor soul. And these are serious things, folks.
Right. And he had a stroke. And so we're helping raise money for his physical therapy and everything else that he needs. And plus we're making this, we're creating a TV pilot. So there's going to be TV cameras there or cameramen there to film it. And so not that it's going to be live on TV, but we're creating a TV pilot and we have producers who are interested in seeing our show. So we need people. We need the money for the donation. We need it. We need it.
So we need help. Help us, guys.
Yeah, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm telling you, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yes.
And there's going to be a food buffet at 5:30. And Sky and I, we're going to start our performance approximately 7. It's going to last a couple hours. And it's going to be like a masquerade party, too. So for the first 50 people who show up with a costume are going to get $5 off their drink vouchers.
Right.
And it's a blast. So,
and I'll tell you something else.
Us.
It's going to be $100 for the first prize for the costume party. It's going to be $50 for the second prize of the costume party and $25 for the third runner-up of the costume party. So look, guys, there's a lot that you can get. There's a lot of happy comedy you're going to see, a lot of happy talking to your relatives, a lot of do you really want to know?
So look at it this way. It could be a date night or it could be girls' night out.
Absolutely.
It's going to be a blast.
We're just going to have such a ball with this, and we're just going to let it rip.
Yeah, it's going to fly.
Yeah, it is. It really is. Too bad we didn't have like 11 hours to do this. When him and I start getting talking on that stage, honey, forget it.
Yeah, so it's going to be a lot of fun.
Please show up. You're going to have a blast.
Check it out. All right, go to my events page on artiehoffman.com. Also, check out my Facebook. I was just on the Q Show out of Philadelphia.
Oh, my God, that's right. He was amazing, folks. If you have YouTube or if you can get a Philly station, look for past shows, because when I saw him, I was just about the proudest person I could be. He was so cool, so calm, so collected, and right on target with his readings. I was like jumping for joy. He was great.
It was a lot of fun. You know, Quincy's a lot of fun, the host.
Yeah.
So go to my Facebook, Artie Hoffman. Just go to my Facebook, and I have the video on there, and you'll check it out. And, yeah, it was my first time on
You were terrific.
It was a lot
You were
of fun.
A natural. You were a natural. God made you to do this. He also made me to do this.
That's right.
There's one thing we don't have, and that is fear of the camera or people. We are outgoing people because we love people so much. And let me tell you something. Tickets, if you want to buy your tickets, they're $55 in advance.
If you buy them in advance. At the door, it's $60. PayPal. It's $55.
And also, they're available at www.artiehoffman.com. So if you want to buy them in advance, guys, you save yourself an additional $5. So, you know, if you want to handle it that way, I would say, hey, save the money.
Yeah, you're going to have laughs. There's going to be answers. Like I said, it's just going to be a lot of fun.
There's going to be a lot of spooky. There's going to be a lot of kooky. There's going to be a lot of laughing, and there's going to be a lot of crying. It's going to be a roller coaster night.
Yeah. No, it's going to. It really is. It's going to be a lot of fun. So check it out. This week, we're going to be talking about that life isn't just about getting to your destination. It's about enjoying the journey or learning from your journey while getting to your destination in life. And so many people stress out about just achieving their goal, or so many people just stress out about retirement or getting to the top of the ladder of their company, or, you know, it's just people are so asphyxiated. I mean, granted, it's important to have goals in life. It really is. But there are people who are so asphyxiated on just having the trophy that they're not enjoying playing the game of life.
True.
And unfortunately, a lot of people end up stepping on other people's toes just to get to their destination or just to get to their goal, which is not kosher. It's not cool. And, speaking of kosher, Happy New Year
to all our
Jewish friends out there.
Absolutely.
Which I happen to be one of them.
I hope everybody had a wonderful Day of Atonement. So today is a fresh start for everyone, right?
And you want to know something? I went to this temple in Edison, right across the street from the John F. Kennedy Hospital in Edison, New Jersey. And it was literally one of the most beautiful services I went to.
Wow.
During the high holidays. And the rabbi, a female rabbi, had a beautiful golden voice.
Female rabbi?
Female rabbi, yeah.
No way. I've never.
I never heard of such a thing.
I never heard of such a thing. I don't.
Until
what?
Just recently, yeah. The Reformed. And
I think that's so nice.
Yeah. And when I tell you, she had a golden voice. And plus, they had a whole choir.
Bless her heart.
And they had a piano player. And it was enjoyable. I was being entertained. It really was.
You know what? It couldn't have been easy for her to make that step in life, being it's predominantly a male job.
Yeah.
It couldn't have been. I give her kudos. God bless her. You see, guys, when it's your calling, there is nothing that's going to stop you. You're going to go like a freight train. And like Artie said about the topic, it's not about reaching the destination. It's about climbing the mountain to the destination. It's like if you wanted to climb Mount Everest, it's all about getting to Mount Everest. It's the oxygen. It's the camping. It's the snow.
It's the
challenge. It's so beautiful. And you have to get into that challenge. Otherwise, what are you going to do when you get to the top? You're going to have a breakdown.
It's just like when people are, you know, doing their job, or they want to, you know, yes, you want to make money at doing whatever it is that you're doing. But at the same token, you want to enjoy what it is you're doing. And don't forget the purpose of why you're in the business of what you're in. If you are really passionate about whatever it is that you're doing, it could be entertainment. It could be retail. It could be healing people. It could be whatever it is that you're doing. When you're serving the public or when you're doing what you're doing, if you do it for the love of what you're doing, the money will naturally be there. If you're doing it for the sake of the money, when you might achieve your goal, but it's going to come in an empty.
It's going to come with a price.
It's going to come with a price, but it's going to come empty. It's going to be that emotional feeling is going to be empty.
It is going to be empty. And you know what? A very smart man said to me, if you love what you're doing and you're enjoying getting there, then you're never working a day in your life. And that's all about the journey there. You've got to love what you're doing, because the journey is not the culmination, but the process to a finish. It's the process to a culmination of your life choice. Very important, folks. Don't ever forget that.
Like I said, do what it is that you're doing with passion. Do it for the love of doing what you're doing. And trust me, everything else will fall into place. All right. And sometimes you might not be making the kind of money that you want at the beginning, at the get-go, that you need to survive a life. So what you do is you get another job to supplement your income, but you don't stop doing what you love to do.
Or you panhandle.
Yeah, whatever it takes. Or you borrow money.
That's
or you beg, whatever it takes. But you don't give up your passion. And so many people say, oh, it's too much money, or oh, I'm too old, or you know what? They give up on what they want to do.
Excuses.
I've never given up.
I've never given up either.
Ounce. And a lot of people have said to me, Artie, when are you going to stop? When are you going to stop?
Nope.
And you know what my answer is? Never.
Right.
Because I do have other sources of income, and I keep on doing what I love to do. I make a lot of people happy. And my ultimate goal, and we are just around the corner from
I know
my
it.
Ultimate goal, is from making it big.
Excuse me, I got to stop you for one second because we have to go to a commercial, folks. So listen, stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
It's amazing how you can speak.
The earth is an ever-changing being. Goddess Light Shamanic Healer Bree Gibbs guides us through the ascending worlds and brings forth knowledge and truth. As a light creator, she is here to provide new information needed at this time in our evolution. Join Bree as she shares messages from guides, spirits, ascended masters, goddesses, and others. Tune in Tuesdays at 3 p.m. Pacific and Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific for the Silver Gaia Show and live the authentic life.
Wow. Hey, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. This is Talk Radio to Thrive By. I'm telling you, I got to pinch myself some days because when each of us gets called to do something that we so not thought was in our wheelhouse to do for a purpose that's so much greater than us, we get to show up and shine.
If you would like to show up and shine on the Dr. Pat Show as a co-host or sponsor, send us an email to inspire@thedrpatshow.com.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
Hey, everyone, this is Dr. Pat. I am so thrilled. I've had the honor of working with Leslie Fontaine for the past year or so, and what she has created in her hit program, Sheer Alchemy, transcends what most of us get to listen to or hear in any point in time in our lives. But beyond that, Leslie is working with people all over the world, and she has created something phenomenal based on the feedback and input from the Archangels, from the Ascended Masters, from the light beings, and most importantly, from each and every one of you. So if you want to change your life, if you're ready to step into your own version of Sheer Alchemy, please give Leslie a call at 678-665-3366. And why? Because this is what you're going to be prepared to do. Be amazed, and on your part, connect with the Ascended Masters that are there to help you custom make the life that you are meant to live.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman, as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Darkness. night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound.
Welcome back, folks, to another few minutes.
Yeah, we just have a few minutes left. I'm sorry.
With that long song.
Yeah, it was a very long song.
Hey, listen, guys, we'd love some audience participation today. So if you'd like to call in for a mini reading with Artie or myself, the number is 1-800-930-2819. And if you'd love to get an amazing reading with our star TV celeb, his number is 877. You don't want me to stop that. You know that. 877-ANGEL-02. And if you'd like a beautiful reading with myself, my number is 908-500-1474.
She will blow you out of the water, folks. I'm telling you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So give us a call, guys. Get a cracking. Become part.
So listen, if you just joined in, Sky and I, I'm telling you, we're going to be doing a live comedy show at the Stress Factory in New Brunswick, New Jersey, November 2nd. 5:30 is food. 7 o'clock is the show. And we're going to be doing comedy. We're going to be speaking with dead people. We're going to be giving psychic readings.
Yep.
There's going to be the Michael Jackson Thriller. There's going to be the Rocky Horror show. Yeah, the Rocky Horror Show. There's going to be a film clip of there with the dancing and stuff. So that's going to be great.
And a buffet.
That's what I said with the food. Oh. And it's all inclusive. So go to my events page, ArtieHoffman.com. I promise you, you're not going to be disappointed. It's going to be a high energy night. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're doing it. We're raising money for our friend Carl, who has had a stroke and he needs money for medical expenses. So we're doing a benefit. And it's going to be a lot of fun. And also, we're creating a TV pilot. So we actually have TV producers who are interested in seeing how well we do. So we need people in the audience to be a part of all this. We don't want to do it to a empty audience. That would suck.
Yeah, it doesn't. It's not as effective.
It's just not as effective. No matter how hard we tried before, it just doesn't work the same.
So come on down and have a blast. And guess what, folks, all you Catholic people out there, guess what night that is?
It's All Saints night.
It's All Saints Day. I can't believe it. That is like right there is an omen.
Yeah.
To come on out, enjoy All Saints Day with everyone.
Yeah, we were supposed to be on October 26th, but yeah. The Stress Factory, by accident, they have three bookers there. And one of them already booked that date. And so the girl who was booking us booked us for the same date and didn't realize it. So when I went to, you know, talk with them to discuss details, the girl who was there said, that date's already booked. And so I kind of like...
How lucky.
So I freaked just a little bit. So they managed to get us 1 week later, which is November 2nd. Even though it's right after Halloween, it's still going to work out really good because...
It's only a couple of days.
Yeah, because it's All Saints Day, and it's going to be great. It's going to be a lot of fun.
And so. I think the Saints have a lot to do with that. I think they want to enjoy and visit with us that night, too.
Yeah, so it's going to be a girls' night out. It could be a fun date night. So, you know, step out of your comfort zone. Step out of your rut, your routine, and go
just
there.
Just do it for yourselves, even if you're alone. Just go and have a blast because there's going to be so many people there that you can meet. You know, so come on down. You know, I get a lot of readings that I do. How am I going to meet guys? How am I going to meet guys? How am I going to meet girls? How am I going to? This is the way to do it, folks.
For a second, when Sky said, how am I going to meet guys? I was like, she's married. She's still saying, how am I going to meet guys? I was like, I need you guys there.
Yeah, no. Look, a lot of my clients want to know how to meet the opposite sex. This is the way to do it. You take yourself out of your comfort zone. You come down and you have a freaking blast with us.
It's going to be great.
It is. It's going to be a lot of fun. And everybody's going to be in such a great mood, too. So it's going to be easy to pick up guys, and it's going to be easy to pick up gals.
Yeah, when everyone's in a good mood or loaded.
Yeah.
So it really is. So, but in any case, to shift gears just a little bit, because we only have a few minutes, so we go to break. And so just wanted to talk about, you know, about the destination. You know, like I said, a lot of people are so asphyxiated with retirement, and they're asphyxiated.
That's about, my husband.
About trying to get, well, right now he's close to retirement age, so I can understand it. But that's a little different. But when you're younger, so many people are worried about their IRAs and their 401s. And, you know, I need to save up money for my kids, for college. And so, and they're 3 years old.
Right.
All right. Granted, you save up money. You do what you got to do. But the enjoyment of life is about literally enjoying it day to day, taking life day to day and making the best of it. And like I said before, it's very important that you enjoy what it is that you're doing, so that you don't make it just about the money. But when you keep on doing what you love to do, eventually the walls are going to come down. Eventually things are going to happen. You create your own good luck. You create by meeting new people. You open up new situations, and that's the universe opening up for you. And what I've noticed a lot of times is that people forget, like after they've been in the business for a while, they forget the original reason why they even joined or started what they started. Then they become more asphyxiated about, oh my God, I didn't make as much money. And all of a sudden they start making it about the money. And then everything starts to go in reverse.
Right.
Because you stop playing the game that made you successful.
But you know what? I blame media hype. Everybody wants to make a dollar these days. So all these commercials are about IRAs, start young, take out life insurances that you can draw on at age 21. For crying out loud, do you really think you need to take out a life insurance policy at age 21 when you don't have a family, when you don't have children to worry about? I mean, I could understand, yeah, if you have kids to worry about, you have a wife, a home. But come on, folks, do you really need an IRA? Do you really need it so young? You have your whole lives. You have your whole life. But that I blame on media hype, because everybody wants to make a buck. Remember that. Everybody wants to make a dollar in the insurance business. Everybody wants to make a dollar in the finance business. And they're hyping you to the point where you lose your happy drive to get to the top. You lose your memento. And all you think about is getting there, not the road to get there. It's like, who the hell cares about getting to Paris if the ride from one station to the next station
isn't
a happy time? You know, if you have to deal with the train stopping and breaking down, this, that, and the other thing, who the heck wants to even go? You know what I mean? So get on the track. Get on the path where you enjoy every moment to get to your career.
You'll just deal with it as stuff happens. You deal with it, you go day by day, and slowly, you know, it is important to have goals. And I'm going to make a very strong, wonderful suggestion. So when you leave money to your kids, all right, or you leave money to your child or to whomever, and you're worried about, will they spend the money foolishly, whether you leave $50,000, $100,000, $1 million, whatever it is, what I've done, all right, because I've left my daughter, you know, a couple hundred thousand. So what I did was, if I was to kick off tomorrow, I have it within my will that she's to receive $40,000 every year for 5 years.
That's a good deal.
So, and then the last year, it was actually 250. And then the last year she can get 50. But rather than give it all up front right away.
That's very good.
You know, because kids, you know, they're young. They're not always the smartest. So I paste it so that, you know, if she screws up or whatever, she wants to have fun with it, she always has something coming in for the
next year. And $40,000 could be a very nice down payment on a house.
And it could also be a good time for a break. So we're going to go for a commercial break, everyone. So stick around. We're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
Tune in to the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegell every Thursday for a two-hour show, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Artie and Sky deliver spiritual and motivational messages with passion and a sense of humor. Call in 800-930-2819 for live and on-air readings. Visit ArtieHoffman.com and skyofangels.com.
October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. To celebrate, the Holistic Medical Center is offering a 25% discount to patients on all thermography during the month of October. This is a safe, pain-free, radiation-free, and accurate way of screening for cancer and abnormalities. Find out if you are at risk. For more information, visit holistique.clinic. That's holostique.clinic.
TheAngelLady.net.
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 TheAngelLady.net. 1-800-323-1790. 1-800-323-1790. Sue Storm.
Sue Storm.
TheAngelLady.net.
Are you sick of feeling overworked with no motivation? Take a break from the daily grind. Life coach Nicole Eisler is here to provide a healing journey of optimism. Passionate and caring, Nicole is no ordinary soul. Her dedication to helping everyone has no limit. Witness the power of positivity. Tune in every first and third Tuesday at 4 p.m. Pacific for Positivity Party Radio with Nicole Eisler on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit BigDreamAwakening.com.
Have you felt a lot of fear and self-doubt in your life where you feel like you never know what's right for you? As a result, maybe you've made yourself invisible or haven't fully put yourself out there. Hi, my name is Deb Acker. In addition to being the host of Truth Talk Radio, I'm an intuitive life coach and energy healer. I clear energy blocks to all areas of life, including stepping into your power to be confident and visible in your relationships and the world. Did you know fear, self-doubt, feeling invisible, and not feeling comfortable to put yourself out there are all linked to not being in your power? What if you could always feel powerful and on purpose at all times? I used to spend a lot of time hiding in fear and self-doubt. Now I'm not afraid to put myself out there on a bigger scale, and most importantly, I know what's right for me in every moment, and I take action accordingly. On the other side, I now help others with this, and if you're ready to be powerful and confident and let go of the fear that holds you back from a bigger life, I'd love to gift you with my pattern identification session. Simply contact me on the contact page of my website, deborahacker.com. That's deborahacker.com. And let me know you heard about this gift through Transformation Talk Radio. I look forward to connecting soon.
Just an old-fashioned love song playing on the radio, and wrapped around the music is the sound of someone promising they'll never go. You swear you've heard it before as it slowly rambles on. No need in bringing them back, cause they're never really gone.
Just an old-fashioned love song, one I'm sure they wrote for you and me. Just an old-fashioned love song, coming down in three-part harmony.
To leave our dreams upon and listen to each evening when the lights are low. To underscore our love affair with tenderness and
really
fear
don't want
that we've come to know. You swear you've heard it before as it slowly rambles on and on. No need in bringing them back because they're never really gone.
Just an old-fashioned love song, coming down in three-part harmony. Just an old sure they wrote for you and me. Just an old-fashioned love song, coming down in three-part harmony. Just an old-fashioned love song, well, I'm sure they wrote.
All right, welcome back, everybody. You're with Artie and Sky, and
or Sky and Artie,
or Sky and Artie, whichever. I don't care
the
what
four
the billboard.
Of us. Yeah, the four care. Of us.
I don't care what the billboard says.
Me
I don't
neither,
care
guys.
How it reads
me neither.
Yeah, it makes no difference.
Really?
So long as the bottom line is that we're there.
Yep, Me too.
So, yes, we're making our own prediction. We will be in Vegas. We'll be in L.A. Well, we will be on TV.
We're going to have – we also predicted we're going to live next door to each other on right. on – what is that, Rodeo Drive? No, that's where you shop.
Rodeo Drive.
Where's that place near the ocean?
I don't know. There's a whole lot of ocean out there on the West Coast.
Yeah, where the stars live.
Where the stars live?
Yeah, the ocean. What do you call that?
Malibu?
Malibu. Malibu.
Where Charlie Harper lives.
Where's that?
From Two and a Half Men, Charlie Harper.
Oh, I love him. Oh, my God. You know what? He is kind of a degenerated person only because of the things you hear. You really don't know the truth, guys, honestly. So that's why I never judge anybody, because it's always their story, his story, and then the truth.
Right.
But I think he's a really funny guy. I happen to love that dry humor.
You want to know something? When I listen to him, like, live, when I listen to him on talk shows and stuff as a person,
yeah.
There's really not too many people home upstairs. Seriously. When
really?
Yeah.
Well, that's
he doesn't have that flavorable personality. He doesn't. He has a dynamite personality up on stage. And when he's performing as Charlie Harper, as.
Yeah, it's because somebody's writing his words.
Yeah. And he's phenomenal at it. He's really great at it. But a person who really got, you know, who I think very highly of is Robert Downey Jr. I think
he's brilliant.
Bomb. He's the bomb.
He really is.
He's a great comedy actor.
I love him. I just saw him in a movie last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah, his wife is having a baby, and he goes on a road trip, and he meets this guy, and I forgot the guy's name. He's really a funny guy. Uh-huh. Chubby with curly hair.
Oh, really?
He played in The Hangover.
Oh, okay.
As the weird one.
Okay, okay.
And they're on a road trip together, yep. And he's got to get
I want to see that, yeah.
Oh, Artie.
It's out on there now?
It's now, it's yeah.
I got to see it.
When we go back to my place, I'll put it on for you.
Absolutely.
It's hysterical.
And guess what? We're going to be hysterical on November 2nd.
We sure are, folks. You got to come. I'm so excited for you guys to be there. I really am. Because you get to see the faces behind the voices. You might not like that.
You'll like it.
But you're going to have such a great interaction, because we really want to interact a lot with the audience. It's not only going to be us up there. It's going to be you guys are going to be part of the show, too. And that to me is really important.
We're going to be making everyone a part of the show. We're not going to be able to read for everybody because there's going to be too many people.
Yeah.
But we're still going to have a blast, and we're still going to be entertaining.
I want to tell you.
And it's really good. It's going to be a lot of fun.
It's at
the Stress Factory on November 2nd. Go to my events page on ArtieHoffman.com, and you can go right to PayPal and order your tickets.
I'm going to tell you something, and I meant to tell you this before the show.
Talk to me, darling.
Okay. I was in my car driving this afternoon. And I was thinking about the show, and I was thinking about the audience, and I am saying, you know, I hope really important people come that are really loved ones to, you know, the folks in the audience. And all of a sudden, a veteran came to me, a vet who had passed away. He was literally blown apart, and they couldn't even salvage any of his body.
Wow.
And he wants to come through for somebody in the audience. He came now to me.
Wow.
So, like, he's going to be the first that I single out. And they... Folks, if they salvaged a finger or an arm, it was a lot. And his family is devastated, and he wants to bring a message out to the woman that he wanted to propose to. And I saw him on one knee handing her a ring. So he wants me to tell her, I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to tell you in life, but I love you, and someday in heaven we will be married.
Wow,
is that amazing? I started to cry.
It's funny that you should say that, because in my thoughts, you know, it's on the same premise. It's not that I connected to that guy, but in my thoughts a couple of days ago, that here you are saying, you know, I love you and I want to marry you. My thoughts the other day was, it's better, and I was going to make a post up. I want, it's better to say I love you to the person in front of their face than to their tombstone.
Absolutely.
If you have that,
Artie, that is the most
and
brilliant.
And I kept on saying that, and here you are talking about this guy, about.
You were supposed to say that.
So
that's the most brilliant thing I've ever heard you say, because you know what?
Lots of brilliant things.
No, you were just sleeping. No, this is the most brilliant. And I'll tell you why, folks. When you live through something like this, you know how important what he just said means. So never go to bed mad at each other. If you're having an argument with your kids and they live someplace else, you know what? Break down and call them and say you're sorry. Make sure that you tell somebody that you love. Never go to sleep with a grudge. Always tell them how much you love them. Make an effort. So what? So you don't look in control? But you know what? You are in control when you do that.
End the day
at the end of the day, whoever you're sleeping with or with your kids or your family, end the day with your I love yous, or let them know, or that you're not angry. And you want to end your day on a high note. And,
with a blessing to them.
Yeah,
and tell them literally with your mouth, I love you. Even though you could hate them for the moment and what they're doing, you love them unconditionally. And that's what you got to make them know. I might hate what you're doing, but that doesn't mean I don't love you. I love you. Good night.
It's a love-hate relationship.
It's true. It is a love-hate relationship. Look, nobody likes everything everybody does. Does that mean I judge you and hate you for the rest of your life because I don't like the way you eat Twinkies? Because you get the cream in the corner of your mouth and you look like you're foaming?
You know, it's something I used to say that because it got to a point in one of my past relationships where, you know, over the years, you know, a lot of people end up staying in relationships where they should have, like, left, like, you know, 15 years ago.
Yeah.
And it got to a point in one of my relationships. In my first marriage.
Exactly
in my first marriage.
What we were talking about.
Yeah. It got to a point where I didn't like the way she drank. I don't like the way she ate. I hated the way she walked. I hated the way she counted money. I couldn't stand it. And I didn't say anything. But it's like when you hate – when you resent the fact that your partner is still breathing.
You're making me cry. Still,
if your partner is still breathing and you resent it.
I hate the way that bitch breathes.
Damn, I hate that. Will you stop doing that? You know, when you get to that point, know when the show is over, right?
This is so true. That is so funny. Look, you brought tears to my eyes. Because I knew who you were going to say. Hey, folks, you know what? I share everything with you guys. You know that, right? So I want to share this one little thing with you. And I'm not even sure I shared it with you. I got a new puppy. I got a brand new little Neapolitan Mastiff. Her name is Piranha. Because she's eating my feet, my ankles, my pants, and everything in view. She ate my mail yesterday.
And watch, it's going to get worse. I want to say, I told you so, calling her Piranha. That's a bad affirmation.
Her name is really not Piranha. Her name is Zaza. Zaza.
I can't say Zaza. I'll call her Zaza.
No, it happens.
I don't care.
I looked it up.
It's annoying just to say Zaza.
It's a Hebrew name. Hello?
Good. Zaza. I could deal with Zaza.
No, her name
easier.
Is not Zaza. Her name is Zaza.
Uncle Artie is calling her Zaza.
I'm going to tell Uncle Artie to eat your feet. Go for his sneakers.
That's okay. I don't care. I'm wearing my sneakers. I won't care about that.
Listen, her name is Zaza. Z-A-Z-A. It just came to me out of the clear. I love the name. And I happened to say to my husband, let's look it up and see if it really is a real name. And it happens to be a Hebrew name meaning belonging to all.
Really?
Yes. That is so incredible.
That's cute. Well, the dog is cuter than cute.
Isn't she?
Yeah.
He tells me the other day, oh, she's flawless. Aw, that was so sweet from her Unky Punky. Yeah. Her Unky Punky loves her too bad.
What do you keep saying to bed? I don't know. Is that
too bad?
Wait, B-A-D or yes. B-E-D?
No, B-A-D. Like you love her so much that you love her too bad.
You love her too bad. I never heard that before.
I know because I made it up and it means such a big thing to me. Look, when you're saying I love you too bad, meaning like
it sounds to bed.
Not to bed.
But that's exactly what it sounds like.
Too bad.
Yeah, but it's
too bad.
There's a difference.
Is that
when
better?
Somebody says, yo, man, you're bad. See, when somebody said, man, you're bad. See, they're saying,
well, that's
bad.
What I'm saying.
I know, but
I'm loving you too bad. Like to the utmost.
See, but when it comes off that way, it the whole time since forever to maybe a few beds ago. I thought you were saying to bed. What the hell's to bed?
No.
I love you to bed. I want to screw your brains out. I love you so much to
not
bed.
Not to bed.
Well, that's exactly what it sounds like.
No, it's too bad. It's like you're a bad dude.
Yeah, but I'm saying, see, when you say it like that, you know, when somebody said, man, you're bad. You're bad. That means you're good.
You'd
man,
be a
that
bad,
was bad. You're sick, man. That was sick. That's good.
No, it's not good. It's bad.
Yeah, it's just the two. When you add the two part, it sounds like
I love you too bad.
Yeah, hello. All right, well, we're going to love you even more after
Let's go to a break.
Stick around, everybody.
Tune in to the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegell every Thursday for a two-hour show, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Artie and Sky deliver spiritual and motivational messages with passion and a sense of humor. Call in 800-930-2819 for live and on-air readings. Visit ArtieHoffman.com and SkyOfAngels.com.
Tune in to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly Neff. This hit show will illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. Renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake to the greatest version of yourself. Learn to tap into your intuitions, think critically about our world, heal emotional and psychological wounds, and follow your passions to live your dreams. The Lucid Planet. Welcome home. Visit LucidPlanetRadio.com for more information.
Sky Siegell co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Would you like to experience life-transforming adventures in personal expansion and world service? If you do, tune in to learn about magical innate abilities that you can develop and use to make your dreams come true. Joy Elaine is author of The Joy Chronicles, and she's inviting you and millions of others to join her in working with galactic masters, angels, and the Ashtar Command, as they assist humanity and planet Earth to achieve their ultimate destination of ascension. For more information about this upcoming event and broadcast, visit joyelaine.com. That's joy, E-L-A-I-N-E.com.
Chris Stainis is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
It's a beautiful morning. I think I'll go outside for a while and just smile. Just taking some clean, fresh air for me.
No sense in staying inside.
If the weather's fine and you got the time, it's your chance to wake up and plan another brand new day.
$98.
There will be children
with robins and flowers. Sunshine caresses each new waking hour.
Welcome back, everybody, to another segment of Angels and Answers with our distinguished Artie Hoffman, television and superstar.
Well, thank you very much.
And the little old me, Sky Siegell.
Thank you very much. I'll bring her along.
He's schlepping me like a backpack.
There you go. Come on, I got some Kugel pudding for you.
Oh, I'm coming. Oh, tell me what you ate last night for the fast break.
For the fast break, what did I have?
Because I know your sister-in-laws are amazing cooks.
No, well, I broke it early. I had peanut butter sandwiches.
Get the hell out of here. I can't take you.
No, if I was to be at my brother and sister-in-law's house and did it the normal way, yeah. Because I ended
I'm shocked.
Up, no, because last night I was at Ocean County College. I was waiting for a bunch of people, so I had to finish it off early. But see, I do everything from the spiritual sense.
Yes.
You know, so to get let everybody in. Yesterday was Yom Kippur. I'm Jewish, raised Jewish, born Jewish, yada, yada, yada.
Very big holiday, folks. Amazingly large.
You know, and so, you know, this is the Day of Atonement where you ask God to forgive all your sins. You know, if I had any, I would ask. But I'm in pretty good cahoots with him.
Oh, is he under a delusion?
You know, I'm on good basis.
He's on drugs.
No, but the truth of the matter is, seriously, I posted up something that God has already forgiven you for all your sins. You're the one that has to forgive yourself.
That's true.
That's where it's all happening.
He's so profound.
I'm telling you. Seriously, I had like 10 straight up posts that I was sending to Alona to post up. I get in this zone.
I know you do. In the shower, mostly.
Yeah, really. Seriously. Like 10 to 12 posts. Boom, 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 boom.
Oh,
and it has to hit me. It can't just like, all right, let me have a post. I have to get in that meditated zone. So yesterday, you know, I went to Temple. I got there late,
but
I got there just when I was supposed to get there. And, you know, I like to sit towards the front of the pews, you know, towards the front of the audience. And I like to just stare at the Torah, you know, where, you know, the Bible is of the Jews and stuff. And I just sit and I like have a little conversation with God. I do. And I ask God for what I want. And I ask God for his forgiveness, which I know is already there. But I feel really good when I leave.
Yeah.
And I was there for about an hour and a half. I mean, granted, it's like a 4 or 5 hour gig, but I'm only there for like an hour and a half. I say my piece and then I leave. And I feel very good like that, you know.
That's beautiful.
You know, I started fast right about at sundown when you're supposed to. You're supposed to break it at sundown, but I didn't because I have life going on. And I honestly believe that, you know, as far as the fasting part,
you did you should have.
Yeah, but right.
For you.
Now, if you're sick or you have circumstances, that's you're not true. Supposed to fast. You're not supposed to hurt yourself. You're not supposed to do that. But if you want to fast just for the sake of fasting, it's very healthy and it's very cleansing.
It is. Are you allowed to drink? Because Richie and I were arguing. Oh, he was right.
No, you're not supposed to drink a drop of water. You're not supposed to do anything. The whole premise is just you meditating to God to ask for forgiveness. And let me tell you something. I had spaghetti and meat sauce. And when you have pasta right before the break, a lot of the Jewish people, they have chicken and they have the protein. And let me tell you something, that doesn't last too long. You
correct.
Know? It doesn't. You need the energy. So
need the carbs.
I fill up on carbs. And it's
very smart.
Very, very easy to go throughout the night. You don't have headaches.
Right.
And then the whole time, you know, a lot of times people are just, all they're doing is thinking about sleeping, thinking about eating. You know, they just can't wait. It's not, the holy part isn't about not eating.
It's when you feel hungry to pray.
You know, it's just about praying. No, it's not feeling hungry to pray.
Oh.
The purpose is just being able not to eat, not to do any activities, not to think about anything about it's your relationship between you and God. And you pray and you ask for forgiveness or you ask for your blessings to be answered, whatever it is you want. So So I, the good fella that I am.
Oh, you're a good fella?
I'm a good fella. I make my donations. Oh, yeah, I ask God for his forgiveness, which I know is already happening.
Absolutely.
And it was really nice because the people at this temple where I was at, the rabbi, it was a female rabbi. She had a golden, beautiful, beautiful voice. I felt like I was at a concert. It was that beautiful.
Lovely.
They had a choir. They had a piano player. It was so beautiful. I never went to services where it was that serene.
Beautiful.
And
she had good energy.
She had very, very good energy. And I really enjoyed being there. I really, really did.
Have you ever questioned her about our profession? How did the rabbi? What are the Jewish views on being a psychic?
You want to know something? We're going to have that talk next week because we only have a couple
important.
Minutes.
I think that's important. There's just one thing I wanted to say. My husband is Jewish, and we were having an argument about. I said I wanted to fast, and I wanted to make a big supper tonight, and he said to me, "Well, I'm not allowed to fast because I'm a diabetic. He's a brittle diabetic.
Right.
So I says, "Well, if you're not going to do it, I'm not going to do it." But I ended up eating even less than what I usually eat. And I tried to be very cautious with my food. Even though I'm not Jewish, I respect anything that God brought forward to us as knowledge. So even though I don't follow any religion to the T, I love bits and pieces of God's word. And there are so many beautiful pieces of God's words in the Torah. And Moses made contact with God directly through the burning bush. And I feel that that was something that really needs to be paid attention to. So, you know, I feel as though, and then I'm Jewish through many years of being with my hubby.
The true answers from the Jewish religion, the true answers is through the Kabbalah, which is the spiritual.
Yes. No, you're wrong. Spiritual. You're absolutely wrong. And I read up on the Kabbalah, and I've also taken study courses on the internet. The Kabbalah has nothing to do with the Jewish religion. Nothing. And it's a big misnomer. And everybody thinks that it has something directly to do with the Jewish
faith. And we're going to talk about all this next week. But right now, from my mouth to God's Jewish ears, I'd like to bless all of you with lots of love, health, happiness, and prosperity. Always communicate to the Holy Spirit. Always communicate to the angels. They're always listening to your prayers. All you have to do is just have blind faith and believe. Believe in God and believe
in
yourself.
Trust in you, and you're trusting in him.
And November 2nd, Stress Factory. Go to the events page of ArtieHoffman.com. I promise you, you won't be disappointed. Till next week, everybody.
Love you, folks. Bye.
You've been listening to Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Skye Siegell. Tune in every Thursday for this great two-hour show at 2 p.m. Pacific and 5 p.m. Eastern Time. And remember to call in at 800-930-2819 to get answers from your guardian angels and loved ones. Artie and Skye have helped thousands of people with remarkable accuracy as they tune in, use their intuitive gifts and inner guidance, and communicate with people's angels and loved ones who have passed on. To schedule your session, call Artie at 877-ANGEL-02 and visit ArtieHoffman.com, and call Skye at 908-500-1474 and visit SkyeOfAngels.com for personal or group readings. And tune in next week for this fabulous hit show.